This week, when I woke up on Thursday morning, I discovered a very nice surprise. Todoist has given us rather a large update. Now, there are some changes in this update that you will definitely notice, and that's one of the reasons why I've put together this video, because I want to go through all the changes in this latest update. So before you go any further, just go into your Todoist right now, check this. Now, this is on your desktop and on the web version. I'm not sure, basically nothing's really changed in the mobile app. This is really for your desktop applications or laptop applications and the browser application. You will going to notice some changes, and there are some differences now when you click on a task. And I don't want any of you guys to be surprised going, whoa, what's going on here? I'm going to show you exactly what's going on here, and I'm going to go through all the changes with you and show you how you can just modify your use of Todoist so that you still get the best out of this amazing application. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to ask, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. It really does help to get us up in YouTube's algorithm. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get the latest tips, tricks and news on Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me now take you into my demo account of Todoist and show you all these amazing changes that Todoist has quite brilliantly brought out this week. Okay, let's get started from the top left on the top bar here. What you're going to find is a new hamburger bar. Now, essentially, what that basically is going to do is that allows you to show and hide this sidebar. So just tap on that and you can hide the sidebar. Tap on it again and it will bring the sidebar back. But more importantly, if you just drag over there, you'll see that it says closed menu, and then it's got this M at the side of it. What that means is that you can now just hit the M key and the sidebar will disappear. Hit the M key again and the sidebar will reappear. Now, what Todoist is doing is they're now showing you wherever there is a keyboard shortcut, they're going to show you what the keyboard shortcut is. So if we move across here, we've got Quick Find. Now, Quick Find has always had the keyboard shortcut F, F for find. Now, what's happened here is the Quick Find has moved from the center of the top bar to the left of the top bar. Now, this is just a design tweak, I guess. But what it has introduced, it's kind of reminding us now that we can just hit on Quick Find and then it's got the F. So it's always a reminder that if you want to go into Quick Find, you can tap F. I can type in Barney, which is going to bring up Barney because it goes by keyword, it'll go by label, it will go by project, whatever you want to search for, it's going to find it. Todoist search is fantastic. Now, from here, if you want to go into details, if you tap on Give Barney's Bath, that's going to open up the task view. Now, what you'll probably notice, for those of you who are very observant, you will have noticed that the task view has now showing in the middle of the window instead of to the right of the window. And it took me a little while to figure that one out. I knew something was different. What's happened is they've moved it now to the center of the bar. And what this does actually is it makes it much easier when you're using a widescreen or a big monitor. You can actually, it just sits better on the actual window. But that goes straight into your task view, and then you can do whatever edits you want to do to the task. To come out of that, you can either tap to the side of it like that and you can cross off. Going across here, we've got the plus sign, which has always been there, which is for quick add task. And if you think of quick as in quick add task, that means all you need to do is type the Q and then you can bring in this is a new task. Hit the add task and that's going to go into your inbox right there. So that's another way, and getting used to that, using the Q when you're in Todoist, that's a really fast way of getting your tasks into Todoist. Now, moving across here, what you may have noticed, again, the observant ones of you will have noticed that this has changed. The karma points has no longer showing. Instead, what you're seeing is your goals for the day, your task goals for the day. So if you tap on that though, and you do want to see your karma, you can just click on the karma and you can see right here how many karma points you have. Now, this is my demo account, so obviously there's not that many points in here, but that's just going to show, and it also shows you how far away you are from your next karma level. So if you tap on there, if you're just curious about what your karma levels are, This will tell you that I'm an intermediate at the moment. My next one is to be professional. That's really cool. So there you go. In my main account, for those of you curious, in my main account, I have actually hit the 50,000 plus. I am enlightened, which is really nice to know. So there you go. So that's your karma. So that's actually really useful for those of you who are tracking your tasks for the day. You can actually see how many tasks that you've completed for the day. And then your notifications and your settings have not changed. They're still the same. Now, over in the actual window, your task window, what's going to happen now? When you tap on a task, you're going to go straight into the task view. Now, I saw on Twitter a few people not liking this. Personally, I really do like it. I think it's really helpful because I do a lot of my task editing from this. I find it's just a much cleaner way of editing a task. But if you wanted to do a quick task, a quick edit, you've now got this icon at the side here. You've got this edit icon. And what you can do is just tap on that and it's going to bring up the traditional, if you like, the old fashioned way of actually editing a task. But you can actually do that again. So if it, as you see, when you do that, Alt and click. So if I hold the Alt key and I hit click, that's going to now show me the traditional, the old-fashioned way of doing my editing my task. So there you go. You still have the options. And of course, you can go into schedule and you can go into comments. So what's changed here is we had an information icon there before. And what that allowed us to do was that allowed us to see go into the task edit task view. Now it's default edit task view, and now if you want to go in the old-fashioned way, then you just click the actual edit. So there you go, that's just one of those quick things. And down here, all this is the same, nothing has changed there, everything is pretty much the same. And the final change, and the really observant of you may have noticed this, is that we now have a little bit more space between tasks. You'll find that there's just a little bit more breathing room, and I actually really like that because it gives a very, very clear, and in this particular case, I have 7 tasks here for the day. And usually this is where I'm going to be probably from about mid-morning, because I do my golden 10 every day, or the today's focus task. And that will give me everything I need to be able to see and work from. And it's just a really nice, clean window. And one of the things I did notice is this looks spectacular now in the dark mode. For those of you who like the dark mode, this actually looks really, really cool in dark mode. And if I close that, I just think it looks fantastic in dark mode, and the colors really pop on the background, which is unusual for quite a few dark mode. I often feel that some apps are just adding dark mode because that's just something they feel they have to have, and they don't really give it that much thought. It looks from here that Todoist has given it a lot of thought, and it does look fantastic. So there you go. That's just a review of all the recent updates in the latest update version of Todoist. It is now available. This is not beta. This is actually out now. What you're going to look for is just look for the little orange indicator on your settings there. That tells you that there's an update. When you click on that, it'll give you the option to update, which is roughly around about here. It's not showing it here because I've already updated it. And you can then go in and get your latest version of Todoist. So there you go. Thank you very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. Now, I have a question for you. Are you ready to go beyond the to-do list? Now, I ask that question because building a to-do list, building an organization system is really the first step to mastering the art of productivity. If you really want to take yourself to the next level and you really want to automate the whole process, then you need to start using workflows. You need to start building workflows because it's the work that you do consistently over a period of time that completes projects, achieves goals, and takes you to accomplish the things that you really want to accomplish in your life. And that's why I developed my Productivity Masterclass series, Building Your Very Own Custom Workflows. Now, this is a course that is kind of on the advanced level. It's designed to get you to go beyond the to-do list, which many of us have spent many hours building, and it's designed to take you to the very next level so that your whole system is automated so you can make decisions really quickly about what it is you want to do today, this week, this month, and this year, and build it into your daily workflows that takes you towards accomplish them. Now, I would love to see you in this course. The details of my Productivity Masterclass course, Building Your Very Own Custom Workflows, are in the show notes below. I would love to see you in the course. I'm sure you will not be disappointed. It'd be great for you to join us. Thank you very much for watching this. It just remains for me now to wish you again a very, very productive week.